Welcome back students. Today we will discuss Battle model. So what is the battle model? This is a destructive type competition of battle between two opposite groups. So the two groups may be of human armies or some athletics or any two groups may be there. So this model is given by F.W. Lanchester in 1920, and this is known as the contribution to the theory of fight. So in the model, he considered two types of armies, and one is known as Red Army and other one is known as the Blue Army. So he takes some assumptions during developing the models, because already we have discussed always assumptions are needed to develop a model. So first assumption, population is sufficient large. Means we assume the number of soldiers to be sufficient large so that we can neglect the random differences between them. And second one, there is no reinforcement or no operational losses, right? Like any occurrence of the disease or destruction, etc. So now we come to the main part of the model. Suppose these are two different compartment. This first compartment represent the red soldiers and second one represent the blue soldiers. So there are some deaths in red soldiers and there are some deaths in blue soldiers. So deaths in red soldier is due to the presence of the blue army, and the death in the blue soldiers in the presence of the red army. So what will be the rate of change of the red soldiers? Means you can write down in the word equation as. So rate of change of the red soldiers means, because the red soldiers, this one and this is the outgoing flow. So that will be the negative sign. And as well as for the blue, there is the negative sign. And this rate, so rate, red soldiers bounded by the blue army. So we will discuss it by the channel equations as before we have discussed some models. But before it, we will discuss that there are two types of scenario. One is the aimed fire and other one is the random fire. So what is this? This is the main concept in this model. So in a real battle, there will be a mixture of the sorts. Those fired directly at an enemy soldiers and those fired into an area known to be occupied by the enemy. Means there are two cases. Means first case where the army used the aim fire, and second case where the army used the random fire. Means enemies are not known, but the area is known. But where the enemy cannot see, this is the second one. In the first case, means there is a aimed fire, means enemy is visible and you can fire by directly. But in the second case, enemy is hidden and you cannot fire directly, but you can fire randomly. So some battles may be dominated by one or other firing methods, which it depends upon the methodology, which methodology is being used in that battle. So for the model, we assume only aim fire for both armies. So first of all, we are considering that both are doing the aim fire, and then we will extend our model when the fire is random fire. So what are the assumptions during when we developing our model for M fire, the rate of soldiers wounded is proportional to the number of enemy of soldiers. For M fire, the rate of the soldiers wounded is proportional to the number of enemy soldiers. Means for the M fire, only the number of the bound soldiers depends only the enemy soldiers, not only its population. This is the first assumption. And for random fire, the rate at which the soldiers are bounded is proportional to the both number of soldiers, means the enemy soldiers as well as its soldiers, its population. So you can see how the model can be write down. So you can use these word equations as given in this, or you can write it as on the page of the general equations. So suppose this model is given as, this is the red army, this is the blue army. Red army is given by RT, is the number of soldiers in red army at any time t is represented by RT, and BT represents the number of soldiers in the blue army, and the death rate for the red army will be the A1B. What is the BB? Is the number of soldiers in the blue army, because the death rate will depends upon, because what is the A1 is the death rate of the red army due to a single blue army, single blue soldier. If there are number of blue soldiers are B, then you have to multiply. So it will become the effective death rate for red army will be the A1B. Similarly, A2 is the death rate of blue army due to a single red army or single red soldier. So therefore, effective death rate for blue army will be A2R. So you can write down the channel equation like this. So these are the two channel equations. So now we can write down the our model. So there are two scenario, one is the random fire and the other one is the aimed fire. So what was the aimed fire? Means that for the aimed fire, the number of death only depends upon the enemies, number of the enemies soldiers, not of the its population. So in aimed fire, so then we will neglect the concentration of the reaction. Means naturally, what will be the equation for this one? So equation for dr over dt will become dr over dt can be written as, because this is on the left hand side, so minus sign will be there. And what is the rate? Rate is A1B and multiplied by A1B and multiplied by R, means concentration of the reactant. But in this case, because the fire is aimed fire, so this R will not be here, means concentration of the reactant is not will be there. So minus A1B. Similarly, for blue army, we can write dV over dt is equal to minus A2R, because this is on the left hand side. So minus sign and the rate and multiply is not will be there because we are considering the angle. That's clear. And now if fire is random fire, then what will be the scenario as normal case? If the fire is random, then there will be the normally as we develop our model. Means this is the rate, effective rate, and negative sign as because this is the on the left hand side multiplied by R. Means the number of death in the red army depends not only on this one as well as the density of or number of in its army as well. So similarly for this one. And next is what are A and A1 and A2? these are known as the attrition rates. So these rates can be defined in terms of the firing rate and probability as well. So A1 can be written as, what is the A1? A1 is the death rate in the red army, means death per capita or per blue soldiers. So A1 will be FB into PB, means this is the death rate in the red army will be FB and PB. What is the FB? FB is the firing rate of the blue army, means this is the rate at which blue army fires. That's clear. And multiplied by the PB. PB is the probability that blue soldiers bounce a red soldiers. Is nothing else. This is the probability and this is the rate. So if you multiply at which rate the blue army is firing, and this is the probability at which probability they are able to bound the red soldiers. So if you multiply it, then you will get the A1, means this is the effective rate of the or death rate in the red army. So similarly, A2 will be the FR and PR, and you can define in the similar fashion as you define FB and P. So FR will be the firing rate for red army, and PR will be the probability of that red army falls to the blue soldiers. That's clear. So we define aim fire as well as the random fire. And third case, or maybe third case, maybe the guerrilla war or some this type of strategy, one army is visible but other army is hidden. Means suppose there may be two cases. If red army is hidden, red army is hidden and blue army is visible to the red army, so then what will be the case? Means this is known as the guerrilla war. So means red army is fighting like a guerrilla war, and other scenario maybe maybe the blue army is hiding. So different type of scenario will be there. So in this case, red army is hidden. So red army is hidden means does aim fire, but blue army not able to the aim fire, and they do the random fire because red army is hidden. That's clear. So red army is hidden. So effective rate will be A1B and multiplied by the R, because the bounding rate for red army depends only this as well as on its density. And for blue army, it will be only A2R, means because the firing of the red army is the aim fire. On the other case, if B is hidden, so minus A1B will be for R, and B means which army is hidden, there will be the additional factor in multiplication. That's clear. So this is the key point to remember. So if we come back to this, our PDF, so I think there will be no difficulty to understand these things. So red, so these were the rates, red soldiers bound by the blue army, as we have already discussed these rates. So this is the system. For which when we are using aim fire, means both armies are using the aim fire. And second case, so these are the interpretation of the parameter, as we have already discussed. What will be the A1 and A2? It's A1 is the FB and PB. That's clear. So you can define these, and these are known as the extinction coefficients. So now you can find out the exact solution. So how will you solve these two differential equations? Because if you want to solve these differential equations, so this is an exercise for you, or it may be coming your exam. suppose we have to solve these two systems simultaneously. So in this case, there is left hand side, there is the R, and in the right hand side, there is B. So how do you eliminate, if you want to eliminate B from this equation, then you have to put it here, dB over dt, and then you can put the value of dB or dBt here. So differentiate both sides. So if you differentiate both sides, then it will be the second order derivative with respect to R, means it will become d 2 d 2 r over dt, d 2 over r over dt equal to minus a 1 and dB over dt, and you can put the value of dB over dt is equal to minus a 2 r, means you can write it as minus a 2 r. And what is this? This is nothing else, this is a second order linear differential equation with constant coefficient, means it can be written as d 2 r over dt square plus dt square plus a1 a2 r equal to 0, and you can solve it easily. Then you can find out solution analytic. So this is an exercise we will discuss in later. So, and we have already discussed what are the limitations and extension of the model. We have already discussed if this is the random fire is using. So random fire, then that will be the system of equations, or sometime random fire is referred as the long range artillery or trench warfare, means range is not reachable to the both army, right? And this is known as the guerrilla war, means this is the one case of guerrilla war where blue army is hidden and red army is visible. So I think this is the simple model, and there are some simulation for this model. So these are the simulations, and they use the simulation based on number of US soldiers in the Battle of Iwo Jima, measured in thousands, right? So there is a battle between Japan and US. So US and gray, and Japanese are the black, are the model prediction from Maple. Means US was this one and Japanese was the black. So this was the model, how they, and this is the time, and these are the soldiers, how the soldiers, number of soldiers decrease with respect to the time. If you want to simulate it, then copy and paste it in the MATLAB. I just write down this code here. So here I have defined this function. Actually, always we have to break the code in MATLAB, this type of model, always in two parts. One is the function and other one is the calling of the function. So which is selected, this is the function where we have to define the system of equation, and this is the second part where we are calling our function and we are defining the parameter. So first of all, we define the function. So function means is using, there are two equations, R dash and P dash. R dash is equal to minus A1B and minus A2R. So this is the end fire, and it is the returning value. They are returning this value, R dash and B dash, and these are two parameters, A1 and A2, and the value of A1 and A2 are taken as this one, and these are the initial value. Initial value are given as 66 and 18. So first one is taken as the red army, and second one is taken as the blue army. So 66 is the, I think, US army, and 18 is the Japanese army. Then we are calling this function. So 40, 45 to solve the differential equation is a function matlab, and at the rate right hand side is the refer of this name, means we are using or we are calling this function here. This is the time from 0 to t, and this is the initial value. And if we get the solution, always it provides two solution, t solve and u solve. In t solve, which provide the time, and u solve provide the state components. So there are, will be the r, u solve will be the two component. One is the r, one is the blue. So r solve will be the first column, and blue solve will be the second column. And we are plotting then t solve versus r solve, and t solve versus v solve. A plot of this is the red, and plot of this is the blue. And if I run it, then you will get this. So blue army will become the zero after, means will be the vanish after 30 days. But the red army will be approximate to the 55 or something. So this is the simple simulation. And if you want to change the equation, then just you have to change, then you will get the value. Suppose you multiplied here by r as well here, then if you simulate, then this will be the same. Now, if the so what is the meaning of this? A1BR. So what will be the scenario for this? Means now blue army is almost constant, but the red army is going to at a very fast rate they are decaying. So you can check different types of simulation based on the different types of the values. So we have discussed or finished the different types of model. In the next chapter, we will discuss the analysis part. How can we analyze these models without solving the these differential equations or system of differential equations? So thank you.